You're listening to Here with the Magic. Welcome to Soundscapes.
Today we're situated in an evolved but deeply familiar part of Epcot, World Discovery. For longtime Disney goers, you'll know this area as being part of Future World East, a place of limitless potential that showcased the spirit of innovation, celebrated human achievement, and provided a glimpse into the future with its marvels of technology and space. World Discovery continues to be a canvas where science, technology, and a dash of Disney magic come to life. The legacy of Future World East still pulses through this area, even as it's evolved to include a broader range of stories, like the ones that stretch beyond our own planet. What's remarkable here is how Disney's Imagineers have blended the old and the new. You see, Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind isn't just a space adventure. It's also an extension of Epcot's original idea of a world showcase, but this time featuring an entire planet, Xandar. We start our journey in the attraction's entrance plaza, in the shadow of a Nova Corps Star Blaster, where you'll also hear the familiar sounds of the occasional monorail passing overhead. Soon we step inside the Wonders of Xandar Pavilion, where we find ourselves in the incredible Galaxarium, a sort of planetarium that goes beyond Earth to connect us to our galactic neighbors. It's edutainment, but fantastically reimagined. The World Mind, a sentient supercomputer, guides us through the experience as we explore the cosmic connections between Earth, or Terra, and the vast universe beyond. Later, the queue evolves into something akin to a museum, where we'll learn more about the Xandarian story and the many similarities to our own. As you listen, keep in mind that World Discovery is an ongoing tale of, well, new horizons. In this reimagined pocket of Epcot, the call to explore is just as strong as it ever was. It simply beckons from a much larger stage, extending from our home planet all the way to the stars.
yours. Welcome, Epcot Terrace. My home planet might look familiar to you, as it shares many features with your Terra. Xandar is known as a peaceful paradise in the stars, a beautiful world filled with land masses and dominated by vast blue waters. From space, you can see maelstroms, powerful whirlpools which we harness for energy. Observe our many atolls, what you call coral reefs, which grace our coastline. Colorful algae bloom in our waters and provide sustainable farming, while also giving Xandar a beautiful shimmering iridescence. Like Terra, Xandar has an atmosphere that sustains life. The blanket of gases not only contains the air we breathe, but also protects us from the searing heat and radiation emanating from our three stars, or suns. I find it fascinating how similar our two worlds truly are. They both share many wonders. You will discover more of them just ahead. Welcome to the Wonders of Xandar.
Flying objects, for
UFOs. Peter Quill told me that many of you Terrans still believe that these UFOs are flown by.
You know, little green dudes with big eyes and small mouths and antennas.
In your Terran year of 1977, your scientists launched spacecraft on an exploratory mission. In the Terran year of 2012, Voyager 1 made the historic entry into interstellar space, the outer limits of your sun's gravitational pull. Voyager 2 entered interstellar space 6 years later, and I detect that both are still sending you data about their surroundings. Most impressive. What I find intriguing is that not only are your Voyagers receiving and sending data, they are also serving as ambassadors, carrying greetings from you Terrans to the universe.
Citizens.
Much of my knowledge of your world came from your great scholar, Peter Quill. However, many of his facts have yet to be confirmed, such as the incredible importance of a legend called Footloose.
Come on.
Through my fellow Xandarians working here at the Wonders of Xandar, I am discovering more about you Terrans. Such as your fascination with eating the turkey leg. Why only the leg? What about the rest of this creature? We are eager to learn the answers to these questions and so much more about your world. In return, we Xandarians hope to share with you more about ours. Although Xandar is 2.537 million light years away from your planet Terra, our worlds are actually quite similar and began at precisely the same moment. We refer to this as Time Zero, before the existence of anything. Our worlds were born of a single point of matter and energy that lasted outward in what you Terrans refer to as the Big Bang. And from nothing came the beginning of everything. Incredibly hot and extraordinarily powerful, this explosion filled the cosmos with a cloud of rapidly moving particles. Over the next 100 million years, space continued to expand, and the particles cooled and slowed. As they coalesced into huge swirling clouds, gravity pulled them into larger, denser clusters. At the heart of these clusters, the temperature rose, and the particles were compressed so tightly they fused, releasing enormous amounts of heat and light. This is how the very first stars in our shared universe were born. The singularity is just one of the commonalities between our two worlds that we will explore today. Welcome, Terrans, to the Wonders of Xandar.
new visitors,
and welcome.
Welcome, Terrans. I am Worldmind, sentient supercomputer of Xandar. Although our two planets are light years apart, our stories were destined in the stars to come together. The early stars of our cosmos were enormous, hundreds, even thousands of times larger and brighter than your Terran sun. Many of these stars grew hotter and denser, until they exploded, creating new stars in a cycle that lasted more than a billion years. Over time, the remnants of these explosions began to swirl and coalesce into planets in your solar system and ours. You Terrans named our galaxy Andromeda, and yours, according to Peter Quill, after a Terran dairy drink. I am still trying to comprehend you Terrans and your terms, but find Milky Way a curious choice. Among the newly formed stars, at the end of the spiral arm of your Milky Way, is a star which you call Sun. see we have new visitors. Welcome, Terrans. I am Worldmind, sentient supercomputer serving the people of Xandar. My data is comprised of the experiences, learnings, and histories of the Nova Corps and the population of Xandar. Our beautiful planet Xandar is known for many things, but perhaps most renowned for our technological advancements. From artificial intelligence to intergalactic travel, Xandar stands at the forefront of innovation. I am Worldmind, the Xandarian supercomputer. My purpose is to preserve the knowledge and history of Xandar. Your scholar, Peter Quill, has been teaching me about your world. He has suggested that if I want to start my journey of understanding the complex and intricate Terran mind, I should look no further than the sage words of a great Terran classic, Hooked on a Feeling. I could not fully comprehend its meaning, but Peter assured me that its words are deep and that Terran's the joy.
Music that moves your soul.
Understanding you, Terran, is just one of the reasons we are here today at Epcot. We hope we may learn from each other and dedicate ourselves to promoting peace through understanding. Xandarians explore the universe in order to gain knowledge about the many worlds and the beings who live there. One day we look forward to hosting you when you visit the Andromeda Galaxy, home to our planet Xandar. Your Milky Way galaxy is home to 100 to 400 billion stars. Our Andromeda galaxy has more than 1 trillion. But because our galaxies were both born of the event which you Terrans refer to as the Big Bang, our stars are quite similar. 93 million miles away from the surface of your planet is the small yellow dwarf star you call Sun. Your solar system and its singular star is quite beautiful. Our Xandarian system boasts 3 stars or suns, 2 yellow and 1 red. Observant Terrans may have noted that they provide the inspiration for the distinctive symbol of the Nova Corps, our intergalactic peacekeeping force. My home planet might look familiar to you, as it shares many features with your Terra. Xandar is known as a peaceful paradise in the stars, a beautiful world filled with land masses and dominated by vast blue waters. From space, you can see maelstroms, powerful whirlpools which we harness for energy. Observe our many atolls, what you call coral reefs, which grace our coastline. Colorful algae bloom in our waters and provide sustainable farming, while also giving Xandar a beautiful, shimmering iridescence. Like Terra, Xandar has an atmosphere that sustains life. The blanket of gases not only contains the air we breathe, but also protects us from the searing heat and radiation emanating from our 3 stars, or suns. I find it fascinating how similar our 2 worlds truly are. They both share many wonders. You will discover more of them just ahead. Welcome to the Wonders of Xandar.
On Xandar, we are never far removed from the natural world, and caring for the environment is one of our core principles. Our lush, exotic gardens are the envy of the galaxy. Xandar features an unparalleled collection of ornamental creations.
Yes, everything we do on Xandar is done with the goal of creating a better way of life for our citizens. Another of our cities on Xandar was designed in a radial pattern. We recently learned that your Terran visionary, Walt Disney, had a similar goal in mind with his early concepts for the experimental prototype, Community of Tomorrow.
We are gratified that you and him appreciate the value of good design and are proud to share our Xandarian's story with you.
Finding quiet moments of joy in the chaotic world around us is kind of our thing, and I hope it becomes your thing too. I invite you to connect with us on Facebook and Instagram. You can also access hundreds of videos on our YouTube channel, including many formatted for virtual reality devices. Links are provided in the show notes. Thanks for being here.